Welcome to Lab 360, for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. Voyager 1 is a space probe launched by NASA on September 5, 1977. As part of the Voyager program to study the outer solar system and interstellar space beyond the Sun's heliosphere. More than four decades after its launch, the Voyager 1 probe is still exploring interstellar space. But it has encountered an issue that mystifies and baffles the spacecraft's team on Earth. Voyager 1 continues to operate well, despite its advanced age and 14.5 billion mile distance from Earth. And it can receive and execute commands sent from NASA, as well as gather and send back science data. But the readouts from the Attitude Articulation and Control System, or AACS, which control the spacecraft's orientation in space, don't match up with what Voyager is actually doing. The AACS ensures that the probe's high-gain antenna remains pointed at Earth so Voyager can send data back to NASA. Due to Voyager's interstellar location, it takes light 20 hours and 33 minutes to travel one way. So the call and response of one message between NASA and Voyager take 2 days. So far, the Voyager team believes the AACS is still working, but the instrument's data readouts seem random or impossible. The system issue hasn't triggered anything to put the spacecraft into safe mode yet. That's when only essential operations occur, so engineers can diagnose an issue that would put the spacecraft at risk. And Voyager's signal is as strong as ever, meaning the antenna is still pointed toward Earth. The team is trying to determine if this incorrect data is coming directly from this instrument or if another system is causing it. According to a NASA release, until the nature of the issue is better understood, the team cannot anticipate whether this might affect how long the spacecraft can collect and transmit science data. A mystery like this is sort of par for the course at this stage of the Voyager mission, said Suzanne Dodd, project manager for Voyager 1 and 2 at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in a statement. The spacecraft are both almost 45 years old, which is far beyond what the mission planners anticipated. It's also in interstellar space, a high radiation environment that no spacecraft has flown in before. So there are bound to be some big challenges for the engineering team. If the team doesn't determine the source of the issue, they may just adapt to it. Or if they can find it, the issue may be solved by making a software change or relying on a redundant hardware system. Voyager has already relied on backup systems to last as long as it has. In 2017, the probe fired thrusters that were used during its initial planetary encounters during the 1970s, and they still worked after remaining unused for 37 years. The aging probes produce very little power per year, so subsystems and heaters have been turned off over the years so that critical systems and science instruments can keep operating. Voyager 2, a twin spacecraft, continues to operate well in interstellar space 12.1 billion miles from Earth. By comparison, Neptune, the farthest planet from Earth, is, at most, only 2.9 billion miles away. Both probes were launched in 1977 and have far exceeded their original purpose to fly by planets. Now, they have become the only two spacecraft to gather data from interstellar space and provide insights about the heliosphere, or the bubble created by the Sun that extends beyond the planets in our solar system. Here's hoping the Voyager team is able to determine the issue or find a way around it, so the Voyager can continue with the great work it has done for the past 45 years. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. Welcome to Lab 360, for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. The Hubble Space Telescope was launched into Earth's orbit by the Space Shuttle Discovery about 32 years ago. Since then, the school bus-sized telescope has been circling the Earth at 17,000 miles per hour, observing faraway nebulae, galaxies, and, on rare occasions, objects in our own solar system. In fact, Hubble has spent only 6% of its time researching solar system targets so far in its life. Regardless, Hubble is vital to planetary scientists in a way that the new James Webb Space Telescope will never be. As part of its Outer Planets Atmospheres Legacy program, Hubble sends back photos of the large planets, notably Jupiter and Saturn every year, so scientists may study for changes in their storms, winds, and clouds. Astronomers have already run out of time to explore the many smaller worlds in the outer solar system. Using Hubble. Once a year glances aren't much, and Hubble isn't getting younger. The new JWST will examine some solar system targets, such as Jupiter's Great Red Spot, but it will primarily focus on deep space, because of its ability to capture infrared light. In either case, we may soon be without an eye in the sky, capable of transmitting images of planets, comets, asteroids, and making new discoveries. Consider what planetary scientists could accomplish if a telescope is always focusing on solar system objects. Is a specialized solar system space telescope, SSST, required? Let us start by telling you, what exactly is the solar system space telescope, and what does it do? It's a large or medium-sized space telescope devoted to planetary research and observations of targets throughout the solar system. We're talking about observations in visible and ultraviolet wavelengths, with excellent resolution and sensitivity. Hubble can do it right now, but Webb, which mostly observes in the infrared, can't. The proposal for this project is doing the rounds at NASA, and the authors want the SSST to be considered for one of NASA's new frontier missions. The estimated cost is around $815 million, which is a bargain. Considering that the JWST cost $10 billion. So, what is the purpose of the Solar System Space Telescope? To aid astronomers in their understanding of time-dependent events in our solar system, such as seasonal changes on planets, dust storms, and even rare comet attacks, as well as a thorough examination of small bodies across the solar system. This new telescope will be able to observe the volcanic activity on Venus and Titan, look for water vapor on the moons of Uranus, study irregular satellites and Kuiper Belt objects, among other things. You might be wondering, why can't we just use the JWST? Webb is fantastic. It has a 6.6-meter mirror, which is 6 times more powerful than the Hubble Space Telescope's 2.4-meter mirror. But it doesn't have the high frequency that is required for UV light observations, which is crucial for uncovering the mysteries in the solar system. In short, JWST is intended to answer questions in astrophysics, rather than planetary astronomy. Let's talk a bit more about the Solar System Space Telescope, shall we? We're talking about a 10-meter telescope here. Although it is intended to be distinct from the JWST, the SSST incorporates some of the JWST's technologies. Because solar system objects are often bright, it doesn't have to be very sensitive, therefore it uses a sparse aperture design to achieve an extremely clear, detailed image. A sunshield is also not required. It will be observing the planets in our solar system, but another area for ripe exploration would be the small, cold, and dark bodies in the outer solar system, which JWST may find but won't have the time to properly characterize. Some of the tiny bodies known to science contain rings that have never been investigated, including Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune's ring systems. The Hubble Space Telescope has done some incredible work, and calling the JWST its successor is a mistake. There is soon to be a major gap in our ability to investigate what's going on in our own solar system, which can only be bridged by launching a new space telescope dedicated to planetary science. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. Welcome to Lab 360, where we give you all the latest news from the world of astronomy. For years, astronomers have known that the Earth orbits the Sun and that the Sun slowly revolves around the enigmatic center of our galaxy. Until now, the Milky Way's core has been only speculated about by analyzing its gravitational impact on its surroundings in space. Astronomers have long questioned what lies at the center of the Milky Way galaxy. Decades of calculations and evidence suggest that at the center of our home galaxy, there lies a supermassive black hole about 4 million times more massive than our Sun. Humans, on the other hand, have never seen it. Is that going to change soon? We believe so. scientists have released the first ever image of the supermassive black hole that lurks there, providing a radically new perspective on our home galaxy. The historic image of Sagittarius A, taken by a global telescope array, known as the Event Horizon Telescope, EHT, indicates a black hole in the Milky Way's heart, which is feasting on hydrogen gas. The Event Horizon Telescope first made headlines in 2019, when it captured the first image of Messier 87's black hole. But this new discovery has gotten scientists bouncing with joy in their seats. The EHT observed Sagittarius A, the Milky Way's supermassive black hole, at the same moment it obtained the data that generated that image. Sagittarius A, on the other hand, proved more difficult to photograph than M87. For one, the EHT's submillimeter radio waves are absorbed by Earth's water-laden atmosphere. Furthermore, in the 27,000 light-years between us and Sagittarius A, gas and dust have scattered the submillimeter wavelengths and obscured the image. Finally, M87's black hole has a voracious appetite and seems bright because it is eating a lot of gas, whereas the material flow into Sagittarius A is considerably more feeble, resulting in a much fainter object. It wasn't simple to capture this image. It took years to perfect the photograph and validate their suspicions. Black holes are the densest things in the universe, and their gravity is so strong that not even light can escape from within. The telescope can detect light in the form of radio waves, emitted by hot gas swirling near the event horizon. The stuff within the black hole's immediate vicinity feeds it, whether it is gas clouds, asteroids, or even stars that go too close and are ripped apart by gravitational tides. Sagittarius A, on the other hand, is starving. The hot gas surrounding Sagittarius A is crucial for accretion studies because it will tell us how much material is captured from the nearby stars. But currently, NASA doesn't have this vital information and can't determine as to why this black hole is starving. The event horizon of Sagittarius A is 51.8 microarcade seconds across the sky, according to the latest photograph. The researchers called the image as the biggest test of Einstein's theory of general relativity ever made, emphasizing that the theory passed with flying colors. It's an ideal setting for studying how gravity behaves in the vicinity of a gigantic black hole. Our explanations for the turbulence in the gas ring are less certain, because M87's black hole is far larger than Sagittarius A, it takes days for changes to appear, but Sagittarius A is much smaller, and the brightness of the ring can vary in minutes as material whips around it. Apart from giving photographic proof that Sagittarius A exists, the new image also supports the hypothesis that the supermassive black hole at the center of the Milky Way is rotating. It also allowed EHT researchers to determine the black hole's orientation in relation to Earth. To reach this groundbreaking result, more than 300 international scientists, support staff, and 8 radio observatories from around the world collaborated together. The EHT team announced that tens of millions of photos from its global network of radio telescopes were combined to create the final image that was shared with the globe today. The team intends to share more photographs and videos of other black holes following their pioneering new discovery of the Milky Way's core. The team has already given us a new viewpoint on the universe, validating Einstein's theories in the process, and all that remains is for them to keep going in the same direction. These are exciting times for science. 2022 has been delightful so far. Well done, NASA. What do you guys have to say? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the latest news from the world of astronomy.